Feature selection is a process that chooses a subset of features from the original features so that the feature space is optimally reduced according to a certain criteria. You may think of it like packing for a trip. You wouldn't bring your entire wardrobe with you, but you would rather choose the essentials. Similarly, selecting the right features optimizes algorithms, enhances model performance, and reduces computational load. Let's discuss the most popular feature selection techniques out there. The techniques for feature selection in machine learning can be broadly classified into supervised and unsupervised. Supervised techniques are those that consider the target variable and can be used for the labeled dataset. They identify relevant features for increasing the efficiency of supervised models like classification and regression. On the other hand, unsupervised techniques are the ones that ignore the target variable and can be used for unlabeled dataset. In unsupervised techniques, methods often include changing the initial feature space into new lower dimensional space in which the changed features capture the majority of the variation in the data. Some notable techniques that come under this branch include 1. Principal Component Analysis or PCA, which is a linear dimensionality reduction method that converts the original feature space into a new orthogonal space defined by principal components. These components are linear combination of the original features chosen to capture the highest level of variance in the data. Next, Independent Component Analysis or ICA, which is a method for dividing a multidimensional signal into its components. In the context of feature selection, ICA can be used to convert the original feature space into a new space characterized by statistically independent components. You may decrease the dimensionality of the dataset while keeping the underlying structure by picking the top k independent components. Next, non-negative matrix factorization or NMF. Now, this is a dimensionality reduction approach that approximates a non-negative data matrix as the product of two lower dimensional non-negative matrices. NMF can be used in the context of feature selection to extract a new set of basic features that capture the important structure of the original data. Next, t-distributed stochastic neighbor embedding or TSNE. It is a non-linear dimensionality reduction method that tries to preserve the dataset's structure by reducing the difference between pairwise probability distributions in high and low dimensional locations. TSNE may be applied in feature selection to project the original feature space into lower dimensional space that maintains the structure of the data, allowing enhanced visualization and evaluation. Next, autoencoder. This is the kind of artificial neural network that learns to encode input data into a lower dimensional representation and then decodes it back to the original version. The autoencoder's lower dimensional representation can then be used to produce another set of features that capture the underlying structure of the original data. Next, under supervised techniques, there are three general techniques of feature selection in machine learning. To name them, filter methods, wrapper methods, and embedded methods. Let's discuss each of them one by one. Number one, filter methods. These methods are generally used while doing the pre-processing step. These methods select features from the dataset irrespective of the use of any machine learning algorithm. In terms of computation, they are very fast and inexpensive and are very good for removing duplicated, correlated, redundant features, but these methods do not remove multicollinearity. On this, selection of feature is evaluated individually, which can sometimes help when features are in isolation. That means that they don't have a dependency on other features, but will lag whenever a combination of features will lead to an increase in overall performance of the model. Here's a general flowchart for their implementation. Some techniques that come under this are information gain, which is defined as the amount of information provided by the feature for identifying the target value and measures reduction in entropy values. Information gain of each attribute is calculated considering the target value for feature selection. Next, chi-square test. Now, chi-square method is generally used to test the relationship between categorical variable. It compares the observed value from different attributes of the data set to its expected value. Here's the formula for the same. Next, feature score. This method selects each feature independently according to their scores under the Fisher criteria, leading to a suboptimal set of features. Always remember, the larger the Fisher score is, the better is the selected feature. Next, correlation coefficient. Now, Pearson's correlation coefficient is a measure of quantifying the association between two continuous variables and the direction of the relationship, with its value ranging from -1 to 1. Next, variance threshold. It is an approach where all features are removed whose variance doesn't meet the specific threshold. By default, this method removes the features having zero variance. The assumption made when using this method is that the higher variance features are likely to contain more information. Next, mean absolute difference, or MAND. This method is similar to the variance threshold method, but the difference is there is no square in MAND. This method calculates mean of absolute differences from the mean value. Next, dispersion ratio. Dispersion ratio is defined as the ratio of arithmetic mean to the geometric mean. Its value ranges from +1 to infinity, as arithmetic mean can be greater than or equal to the geometric mean for a given feature. Higher dispersion ratio implies a more relevant feature. Next, mutual dependence. This method measures if two variables are mutually dependent and thus provides the amount of information obtained for one variable on observing the other variable. Depending on presence or absence of a feature, it measures the amount of information that a particular feature contributes towards making the target prediction. Next, wrapper methods. Now, wrapper methods are also referred to as greedy algorithms. They train the algorithm by using a subset of features in an iterative manner based on the conclusions made from training in prior model. Addition and removal of features takes place. Here, the stopping criteria for selecting the best subset are usually predefined by the person training the model, such as when the performance of the model decreases or a specific number of features have been achieved. The main advantage of wrapper methods over filter methods is that they provide an optimal set of features for training the model, thus resulting in better accuracy than the filter methods, but are computationally more expensive. Here's a general flowchart for their implementation. Some techniques that come under this are over selection. This method is an iterative approach where we initially start with an empty set of features and keep adding a feature which best improves our model after each iteration. The stopping criteria is till the addition of new variable does not improve the performance of the model. Next, backward elimination. Similar to forward selection, this method is also an iterative approach where we initially start with all features and after each iteration, we remove the least significant feature. The stopping criteria continues till no improvement in the performance of model is observed after the feature is removed. Next, bidirectional elimination. This method uses both forward selection and backward elimination techniques simultaneously to reach one unique solution. Next, exhaustive selection. This technique is considered as the brute force approach for evaluation of feature subsets. It creates all possible subsets and builds a learning algorithm for each subset. Then, based on the results, it selects the subset whose model's performance is the best. Next, recursive elimination. This greedy optimization method selects features by recursively considering the smaller and smaller set of features. Here, an estimator is trained on an initial set of features and their importance is obtained through feature importance attribute. The least important features are then removed from the current set of features till we are left with the required number of features. Next, number 3, the embedded methods. In this, the feature selection algorithm is blended as a part of the learning algorithm, thus having its own built-in feature selection methods. If compared with earlier approaches, embedded methods encounter the drawbacks of filter and wrapper methods and merge their advantages. To state, these methods are faster, like those of filter methods, and more accurate than the filter methods, and take into consideration a combination of features as well. Here's a general flowchart for their implementation. some techniques that come under this method are regularization. This method adds a penalty to different parameters of machine learning model to avoid overfitting of the model. This approach of feature selection uses Lasso, which is L1 regularization, and elastic nets, which is L1 and L2 regularization, and accordingly, the penalty is applied over the coefficients, thus bringing down some coefficients to zero. And thereby, the features having zero coefficient can be removed from the dataset. Next, tree-based methods. These methods, such as random forest, gradient boosting, etc., provide us with feature importance as a way to select features as well. Here, feature importance tells which features are more important in making an impact on the target feature. Lastly, in conclusion, I'd like to say that apart from the methods discussed so far, there are many other methods of feature selection as well. Always remember that feature selection is a wide, complicated field, and a lot of studies has already been made to figure out the best methods. It ultimately depends on the machine learning engineer to combine and innovate approaches, test them, and then see what works best for a given problem. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you like my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.